Hey guys, you broke your ribs and welcome back to my 16 Olympic Marseille career mode. Where last time we talked a bit about the Premier League returning, and we said goodbye to Stephen Fletcher. Will he be missed? I don't think so. I mean, Stephen wasn't on the best form, goal-wise, when he left. So, if you ask me, I trade him in. Ben Yedder is going to rock that second striker spot for the remainder of the season. And alongside the Bash of White. For those of you, and yes, I was pleasantly surprised by the result on Sunday. Well, I was pleasantly surprised that Liverpool's defense didn't completely screw him over. Although Roberto Moreno gave it his best shot. Hold up. That fucker bear hope that he is sold before FIFA 17 comes out, because I will make his life a living hell.
Seem to be settling too much, so shouldn't have too many problems.
Team news, and this is the car team. Well, it's pretty fashionable these days, isn't it? The 4-3-3 gives you the three in midfield, which managers like to have extra solidity.
Yeah, that's right. I'm just looking at the two wide lads up top. They are more.
I don't know how I'm going to do it yet, but all I know is I'm going to absolutely ruin his life. For those who are wondering, no, I'm not angry at the team. It's Moreno, purely Moreno. Because he was so bad. I mean, this might actually be worse than the Norwich game. And his double-crossing performance against Sevilla in Europa League final. I didn't think it could get worse, but oh no, I didn't anticipate how bad it was. I'm not going to go too deep into it, because I'm going to go into it in length. In hilarity. Probably. My next Liverpool career movie on Thursday. Hey, but you can bet the anger is there, and it will come out soon.
Good contest between these two as they jostle for possession.
So yeah, the Premier League is back, and the big guns, well, most of them start off with wins. Man United won, Chelsea won, Man City won, albeit barely. Well, Chelsea didn't, barely got past West Ham as well. Of course, Liverpool beat Arsenal. The only, I guess you could say, top 17 who failed was Spurs. All they got was a draw.
One side or another. This went straight at the goalkeeper. Flick on with the header. They kept possession. Slip past the man now.
On the upside. On the upside, you can, you Spurs fans can look at it as you still have more points than Arsenal started with, so there's that. I think Spurs will only get better as the season goes on. Yeah, I think they might get better as the season goes on. Everyone seems to be counting them out of the top four right He's saying they'll finish 7th or lower. I don't know, I mean, maybe if they get, well, if they got a few more that's between Nanez, he's in a very likely situation that they might miss out on the top 4, but I don't know. And Arsenal? Oof. It's like, trying to get... fire out of a nice... this box. It's not gonna happen, is it? It's not gonna happen that Wenger is gonna improve the team. As the fans know, he needs to. It's just the same situation all over again, and Arsenal fans have been through it so much that they're pretty much all sick of it. I mean, I actually feel for him, I really do. I mean, the only position, I mean, it's
cut out the pass.
It has been a glaring hole in our defense for a while, but look, police tried to fix the left back situation when they signed Roberto Moreno.
The goal from Ben Yedder.
No, no, they only made it worse, but but actually it looks like Liverpool might sign a left back because there's been rumors out of every source you can think of ever since the Arsenal game. But Arsenal.
Sometimes it's hard for a team with so much of an advantage.
They're calling for the same thing for next 10 years. An established center, have a 30-plus goal striker. For some reason, Wenger, I'm pretty sure he thinks that the Arsenal fan base is a bunch of idiots. That, you know, you spend 30 plus sign player, they'll be happy. That might work with a guy like Mesut Ozil, who did improve the Arsenal team, but how much will Xhaka improve Arsenal when they have so many midfielders already? And this is their worries from Arsenal fans.
By the defending team. Florian Thauvin.
Things that I've heard.
Substitute is clearly getting ready to come on.
But everyone in the league could tell you Arsenal needed experience center half, and it looks like they're trying to sign me. What's his name from Valencia? The German fella. I can't think of his name.
He's spotting it up now to take the corner.
Mustafi, there we go. I knew it started with an M. I was like,
that is a high class.
I couldn't think of it, but it came to me. So they're trying to sign Mustafi apparently, but as Arsenal seemingly always do, or at least according to their friends, is that they're lowballing and they're trying to save the odd few million. I mean, it makes no sense with Wenger saying that they're, in past years, no quality. Looking for the right people if someone comes available. No, that's not the case at all. You don't wait. No one can it's very rare that a good player will come available. You have to make them available. Like, Man United made Pogba available. Juventus didn't want to sell Pogba. They had no notion of selling Pogba. But United offered the right money, and Juventus said, what? We'll take it. Okay. That's a long one. Maybe we could get 10 Pogbas for that. Especially if Man United's hanging on them. Not like they were a few years ago. Oh. So-called best manager Alex Ferguson in top quality management there, ladies and gentlemen.
Yet another corner. And we've got the details coming up now of the corners.
Arsene Wenger, especially now that they have the TV deal money, has no excuse. He has to go and spend. This is coming from a neutral point. It would be better for my team if Arsenal will just stay as they are. Because if you keep having mediocre seasons, everyone's going to keep improving, and Arsenal will barely improve. And sooner or later, it's going to catch up to them. And Wenger will still be there with multi-million contract, signing maybe 130 plus first season, and still coming up with the same old shit as every other team is improving and passing Arsenal by. That's what Arsenal. I have a feeling that Arsenal fans can see that future where that everyone is slowly passing them by. I mean, they're not going to go from top four to relegation overnight. It's going to take a few years of Wenger pretty much ignoring what the team needs.
There goes the cross. Ben Yedder, it's his third goal.
When everyone in their dog knows what they need. It seems so simple, but it seems like it's foreign to Wenger.
Yeah, and he'll be taking home that match ball with a great deal of pride.
Wenger doesn't seem to want to live in this world where you have to pay big money to get good players. I mean, yeah, you could easily pick up a bargain. I mean, you will stumble upon a cheap gem every now and again, but you can't build a team on ifs and maybes. You have to buy some quality as well. I mean, I'll use Manchester United as an example, and with their centre back Bailey, or however it's pronounced, because apparently the English commentators are saying something else, well, entirely, which really should come as no surprise considering they can't pronounce. Can.
Ligue 1, Saint-Étienne. Mm-hmm. Olympic Lyonnais.
Nil. Instead of pronouncing it as it should be, they pronounce it with a goddamn H.
Lille 1, Nice 0, Angers 0, Bastia 2, Montpellier.
But take him for example. He's a youngish centre back. But Man United bought him. Was it a risk? Yes. But Man United balanced it out. And I hate to say this, United have had the best window. I don't think anyone could argue with that. I don't care who else, who anyone has signed. Man United have had the best window. Ibrahimovic, Henrik Mkhitaryan, and Paul Pogba, and that youngster, Kelly. It's so. Such a good window. It's so annoying.
L'Oreal with 29 points.
Sorry. Something stuck in my throat.
Then reading up the table, second bottom, Troy with 16 points. third bottom, Angers, with 18 points, but only behind on goal difference.
Villa.
Falling are FC Nantes with...
that's definitely not going to fucking happen. Should I take this offer for... Yeah. 2.2? Hang on a second. I just want to see if he's actually in my second team. Before I know it's Silva. He really disappointed me earlier in the season. So, you know what? Go for it. Go for it, man. And no, I still don't know how to actually pronounce her name. Probably pronouncing it wrong. But, what else would be new? Wait, until the day of the, Juventus? No. It's not too signing either. He made a brief cameo in Chelsea's match last night against West Ham, even though it was the old striker guard in Diego Costa who got the Chelsea winner. And how lucky did Chelsea get? I mean, West Ham fans must be absolutely livid after that. They probably thought, oh, what draw? Okay, not the best, not the worst. But on the first day against Chelsea, when Chelsea were dominating, that's a good result. And that was just, that was them up until the Costa goal, and just out of nowhere, boom, Costa. A goal, and they're like, oh, fuck. You could almost see them as well. Oh, I imagine. No, I'm sure we're alive. Who can imagine that? Because I know it firsthand as a Liverpool fan. I've seen Liverpool throw away the almost guaranteed point because he stupidly he didn't capitalize on their chances, and oh, that is definitely not going to happen, PSG. He no. Bad PSG. But I've seen it so many times as a Liverpool fan. When Liverpool go out, have the game of their lives, dominating teams, tons of shots on goal, they're not getting the goal, oh, but you can see it coming, and then out of nowhere, boom, sucker punched with a goal for the other team. The other team could have been a non-factor for the whole game, and then one little coincidence, and all of a sudden, they have a goal. And you're looking around trying to figure out what the hell happened. It's happened to Liverpool so many times, it's actually ridiculous. So, seeing Chelsea get away with it, with a late winner, I was a bit pissed off. I'm not gonna lie, I was secretly hoping West Ham would hold on. I was like, oh, it's nice to see this happen to someone other than Liverpool for once. And I didn't know it probably happens to the other teams as well, but it happens to Liverpool, well, especially last season, it happened so often, it was almost like a weekly basis thing. Like, they couldn't go 5 minutes, game-wise, without being under some
weak challenge, and in goes the
kind of, falling into some idiotic state. No, best to describe it. You switch off for a few seconds, before you know it, your lead is gone, or the other team have taken the lead when it looks like it was supposed to be you? Your team? And especially if your team is dominating? And it's not just real life either. I mean, that happens a lot in FIFA. If there were any FIFA, the other FIFA YouTubers watching, they would be nodding their heads. Like, yeah, he's got a good point. Because we've all experienced it. We've all experienced the game you're dominating, but the guy is defending like a freaking nightmare. It happened to me not too easily in my Liverpool career mode. I was dominating. It looked like I wasn't going to get the goal. Eventually I did. It wasn't really the team that I was playing. It was more the goalkeeper. Because Pantelmon was just on form for Sunderland on that day. Luckily, Sunderland didn't get like a sneaky goal to stick full point. I got all 30 points, but they made it an absolute pain in the backside to get. Like, more than it would normally be. It's not a real life exclusive thing. FIFA in that sense is almost realistic. And you could dominate a match and end up drawing or losing it. On the occasion you might win a match, as I am right now. And it's a debut goal for Mick. They cross in. He headers it. It bounces right as the keeper. If that doesn't bounce, it's saved. But the bounce takes it over the keeper. He's very unlucky, to be honest. But I will take it. It's a debut goal. Oh, welcome to the French League, Michael. Oh, I still don't know how to pronounce your surname. And in flash, I never will. Not that I'm not trying to learn how to pronounce it, it's just, oh my god, why do you have so many letters? There's in such random fashion. A Y, a Z.
That's for Marseille. Half that's drawing to a close with them in front, but not perhaps in four. Maybe there'll be some substitutions for the second half, which could be quite.
And such randomly place-wise. I mean, I have a Y in my name, but it's at the end of the goddamn name.
Straight at the goalkeeper.
I mean, my name would sound weird without it. Because without the Y, I'd be core. Like an apple core or some shit. But that would almost suck. But I generally think his surname could. It benefit from losing a few layers. I'm just thinking out loud here.
That's half time. Signaled by the referee. 1-0 the half time score.
But anyway, in any event, I am 1-0 up in the Copa Nacional, which is the French equivalent of the FA Cup. Of course, I'm already doing great work in the French equivalent of the League Cup.
Usually opens up in a second.
Passes back to the keeper.
I can see myself easily winning the ball.
Marseille. And shoots! Struck the post.
Oh! Oh! Brendan hit with the A shot of dreams, but it hit the post. The shot was brilliant. The finish, not so much. And if Mike was a bit more alert, he would have gotten his second goal.
Real good contest between these two as they jostle for possession. They've got a corner now, and possibly a chance to add to their lead.
And they'll have again! It's going to be cleared.
Sergio Aguero is getting us all hot and bothered here.
Sam has gotten it to Shaquille. He shrugs off the pulling of his jersey. He. Better for him. Not who I wanted to go to, but it'll work. Nastier wins the corner.
Can be a match winner, this lad, but today, no.
Yeah, they're making a substitution.
I think it's a bit hard on him. The supporters seem to be happy to see him coming off.
Yeah, that's the life of a winger sometimes. You are dependent on...
I was lining up a shot now. Oh, Mike. So? Ben Lemp's got that. He's got that well covered. Craigley.
Check there with the cross. What a good piece of.
Oh, cleared for another corner.
Corner now.
Oh, Dunkley goes for the spectacular, but he fucked it up. Oh, no. It was the cag. Play again. Ah, oh, how unlucky. His header went just over the bar.
Brion.
Oh no! I completely Oh my god, what a horrible mistake. And it's my own fault. It is 100% my own fault. Oh my god, I can't believe I did that. I have to fix this and bring on the big guns to pick up for this. Watch this again. Oh my god. I made the most stupid mistake I've ever made in my life. Oh, I may as well score an own goal for the freaking good it was done. Oh, for God's sake. Why? Why did that happen? I wasn't paying attention. Come on. Let's fix this. Chalogu, straight in. Ah, the defense was clear.
Can lay it off to the supporting player.
Bentaleb! What the ball my curve in?
Keep an eye on the tongue.
Please only be yellow. Please only be yellow. Phew. Because sometimes the referee might give red cards for those cramp. I'm off the baller and the ball is sandwich big challenges.
It would be the winning goal. And he could get away here.
Yeah. Chalogu completely ignored the ball for some reason. Hacken! What are you doing to me?
And Yedda.
The Crigley! He scored it! The left back is the hero! Oh my god!
That's magnificent for Marseille to score!
I have to say, he's probably in the match, so. In this match. He's been really getting involved.
That could be the vital goal here.
Let's see the replay now.
And then, that's almost a top quality finish. Ish. That's damn near a striker's finish from the left back. Oh, the left side. It has made up from my silly mistake. The first goal coming from my left midfielder on his debut. Wait, can Brenda finish it? Oh, just wanted to post. The full-time whistle is gone anyway. But Burnett was so close to making it 3. But 2-1 is the full-time score. The goals from Mikel and Dick Craigley, he give me the win. Whew! It looks like it's ranking 7.4. I would have given him much higher than that. He was very good in that game. And very offensive, of which I normally very e against from a left back, but in this case I'll let it slide because this he scores the winner. And whew! He saved my bacon. I can't pretend that that mistake didn't happen, because it did, but at least that makes up for it. Whew. Oh boy, like, you have no idea how relieved I am. Going into the next episode when I play Bordeaux in the semifinal of the League Cup. Is that two legs or is it one leg? Doesn't seem to be saying anything about a second leg. Easy way to tell. Fixtures. Quarterfinal. New. Oops. Semifinal. Nope. It looks like it's win or go home. Okay. Yeah. In the next episode, we will determine the final of the French League Cup. The Lyre he against PSG or Azengio, or it might be Bordeaux against PSG or Azengio. I don't plan to lose. I don't want to lose. You never plan to lose. Who would you plan to? Basically, what I'm saying is, don't miss tomorrow's episode. It will be hopefully not as defense. It's error-ish. Well, my own defensive error-ish. As today's, but it'll still be very entertaining. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. Hopefully you don't miss any future content. And from me, until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.